say a picture speaks a million words. To me a tat is a never-ending verse. A captured moment forever to be yours. I look back just to help you stay on course. A veces caigo bien, a veces caigo mal. Que viva la tinta, carnal.
Into this business back when I was around 15, just playing around with the homeboys and stuff like that, you know. I started, I got a tattoo right here in my hand. This was a while back. An old veterano from Tijuas did this on me, and I saw him use a homemade machine, and I was like, man, that's firme. I gotta do that. I gotta hook that up.
So he just basically came in and said, yeah. Just throw on whatever looks good, man. I said, fuck it, what do you want to do, a jaina or what? He said, yeah, just do a jaina.
Time went by, my carnal Rafa and I, he said, hey, you know what? We got to get some machines together. And I said, all right. So we didn't know anything about machines. We didn't know anything about nothing. We didn't even know where to order them. We're running around trying to get some Easy Rider magazines because I know that they had some ads in the back. And we ordered our first machine, and it was from Joe Kaplan. Didn't know how to run them, they didn't come with instructions or anything. So just working them, and about a year into it, you know, we were, you know, messing everything up, but you know, you didn't know, you don't know no better. You're just doing, just working the machine, just doing your best you can. And my carnal Rafa and I went down to a guy named Kelly Miller, and we asked him, hey, you know, would you show us how to tattoo? And the guy said, yeah, I'll show you guys how to tattoo. I said, serio? He goes, yeah. He goes, I'll charge you guys $50 for each session, come in once a week. My bro and I went in there, and we did that for a while until I got locked up, you know, doing some of the neighborhood stuff, and you know how the lifestyle is. I did this in there on myself, and this was all done with the homemade machine. I did this and learned how to do all this really soft. To me, it was a soft, nice shading at the time, and I still have this, you know, because it's memories, and I'm not gonna cover it up. I'm not gonna change it. Because it's part of who I am and part of what I've lived through.
Aquí estoy haciendo un templo, pero estoy haciendo pura línea de sangre ahorita. Le hice la el diseño freehand, el templo, este es más o menos una idea del templo, pero no es idéntico, le cambié las tres cosas para que se acomode el diseño hacia el brazo.
I got to a point back like in 2000 that I couldn't learn anymore, you know. I got tired of just seeing everybody saying, oh, you're so good, but I knew it wasn't all that. I knew there was a lot more for me to learn. So I couldn't learn it here, so I decided, well, I think I'm gonna go back to the States, and I did. Went back to the States, and I started working back in Stingray Productions with Kelly and my bro, and got back in the game, you know, and I started learning everything from how to do full sleeves, how to do big back pieces, how to actually lay them out, because, you know, you can do a big back piece, but, you know, you also got to keep in mind the aesthetics of how to make that piece look nice with the body and have it flow with the body. I have about 65% of my clientele are foreigners. It's just cats that are coming in from the US or that live here that are basically from either Europe or Canada or the US or even Korea, you know.
Yo soy coreano, me llamo Esteban Park. Puse este símbolo, este tatuaje, porque a mí me encanta la cultura mexicana. Por eso ahí puse el Azteca, es un símbolo calendario de Azteca. Aquí tengo, es uno de los dios de la vida, de la cultura maya. Es que me encanta, me gusta, así típica mexicana. Otro brazo tengo el dibujo el diseño de Gangster. Eso es un diseño de los Gangster, ¿cómo se dice? Mafioso americano, ¿no?
Gangster.
Gangster. Solo quisiera poner recuerdo aquí en México, porque me gustó mucho.
I didn't think I was going to be doing a lot of black and gray and the gangster stuff, because a lot of people don't have the money to be paying a lot of the, you know, the prices that I charge. But luckily I've been tattooing a lot of homeboys that are coming in from the States, Arizona, all of Northern and Southern Cali. They've been coming down and they just happen to walk in, want to get something done, they like the style. I think it's because they feel that they're back home, you know? Some people say, well, what style do you specialize? I'm like, dude, I love doing portraits, but I also like doing some fantasy work. I've done like pieces of like arm sleeves, I've all done Lord of the Rings. I've done other pieces of just straight medieval dragons on back pieces. And I've also done old traditional Japanese style, which, you know, I'm learning more about that because that's a lot to learn from the Japanese style. I mean, my respects, their style. I mean, you have to learn their history, their style, their techniques, and you can spend a whole lifetime learning their stuff.
Heal up pretty nice, and we'll find out once it's all healed up. But I'm pretty happy. I just hope he's happy. You happy, dog?
I'm happy, man.
This industry actually saved my life, man. Right now, I'd probably be doing life or I'd be dead on the calle. But this industry taught me to be a man. It taught me to come out of the slumps. It taught me to get a type of artwork that no other artwork needs this, you know? I know how to airbrush, I know how to paint, I know how to do acrylic, I know how to do this, but nothing's a challenge like tattooing. Tattooing to me has the highest, utmost respect because it's a challenge of every day. Everything you do is a challenge.
Mm-hmm.